In this module, we're going to talk about ARM providers and resources inside Azure. And so just to take a real quick step back, ARM stands for Azure Resource Manager, and it is the deployment mechanism or the way that we interact with Azure. In order for it to build resources and services for us up in the portal or up in Azure itself, we're actually interacting through this ARM module. So it's absorbing everything that we're sending in, and it's able to interpret that and go ahead and deploy those pieces out there. Now, some of the things to think about with the resource providers is they have to be registered. This is not something you can see through the portal or whatnot. You can do this through a script. You can actually restrict who has access to providers. And let me take a step back and say what a provider is. So in ARM, everything inside of Azure, think about first class. And when I say first class items in Azure, I mean like storage, virtual machines, a SQL database, all the things that Microsoft is providing inside Azure. Those are first-class components. They all have a resource provider associated with them. And what it is ARM itself does not know what a SQL database is. It does not know what a storage account is. But it knows how to talk to an interface that can do CRUD operations for it, such as create, read, update, delete, all these types of operations we would need to do with some specific thing in Azure. And so that's where it's kind of decoupled, and all the different product groups have come through and said, okay, when you say create to a SQL database, this is what it means. Here's what we have to do behind the scenes to create a SQL database. When you say create to a storage account, this is what it means. Here's how we create a blob storage account. And so there's a decoupling there. And what's interesting is not only can we do this with first class things like inside Azure, like the things I mentioned, but third parties can actually build providers as well and plug into this model. So in the future, you see those kind of things happening where third parties are able to sort of plug a module into ARM, and it can absorb those commands too for creation, deletion of different resources inside Azure. Now I mentioned that, so those are our providers. The provider is what's implementing the code to say, here's how we do these things. Those can be restricted. So basically we can say, by default, maybe we remove all the providers from a subscription and then we can start to add ones back if we really wanted to lock things down. And in that way, somebody comes along and doesn't have permission to, let's say, a CDN, Content Delivery Network module inside Azure, we could actually restrict that one, and then they can't use that to go ahead and provision those things. So you can, RBAC kind of fits in with this whole ARM module, and that's where you see we had another module on RBAC policies and some of the security mechanisms, and those kind of go hand in hand, and that's how they kind of fit together. But it's interesting when you start deploying all these things out here, and you have all these templates, and you have all these new things that we're talking about. How can you visualize this? I mean, it's a little bit to get your head around, especially if you have like 1,000, like I mentioned before, 1,000 lines of JSON code. How can I actually see what that actually means? And we have some tooling around that. I wanted to ask Ed to go ahead and show some of that stuff for us.
Sure. So if you actually go to resources.azure.com, this is an Azure Resource Explorer. It's in preview right now. But it is a way for you to kind of drill down into your Azure environment and see what kind of resources you have, see the providers that are available to you, and see the visualize those ARM templates. So if you look here, we can drill down into providers, and you see we have the Microsoft.cdn and Microsoft.web, and then we have source controls under this, which would be your Dropbox or your GitHub, so you can deploy from those different environments. But you also can drill down into your subscriptions here, and you can see I have one subscription, and then drill down into providers down here as well, which is all the different Microsoft Azure providers where you have your compute and your storage and your network. And again, like Kale said, those are the providers that allows you to kind of send a create or an update to that provider, and it tells the provider what to do for that resource, and the provider takes that command and then does it however that command needs to be carried out. But then you can drill down here into your resource groups. And you can see I have three resource groups here, and this shows you the different ARM templates for your resource groups and then the resources within those resource groups. So here we have a Data Lake Analytics ARM template that is tied back to my Data Lake Analytics account. And then you can drill down into each of your resource groups here and see all the different resources. We have a storage group or storage resource here as well, storage count. There's another way to get these templates from your resource group through the Azure portal. So if you switch over to the portal here and then you click on resource groups, you can see my three resource groups that we just saw. But what you can do is drill down into these, and you can actually, in the settings tab here, or blade, You can see we have two resources here, but in the settings blade, we can scroll down and click Export Template under Resource Management. And so another caveat with this is that some providers are not yet available to export in ARM templates. So Data Lake is one of those resources. But if we did something like a storage account, and you went down to Resource Management here and went to Export Template, it'll give you that template that you can take this template, you can download it, switch up a couple of the parameters, maybe the storage account name, and then you can redeploy that in your different groups. So when you create a resource group with an entire application with a bunch of different VMs and VNets and storage accounts and whatnot, instead of creating that resource, that ARM template from scratch, you can go to that resource group, export that ARM template, and then change those names or change those variables or parameters, and then be able to redeploy that into different environments, which is a very powerful tool when you have these environments that you need to spin up multiple times.
Yeah, I think it's important to point out what Ed showed there was we have a couple different tools. So the export templates is great because when you export a template, you're actually able to replay that, right, and reuse that. But when you go to resources.azure.com, I look at that more of like a dump tool, right? So this is dumping what's up there. It's really great for diagnostics. I've had cases where, because ARM's asynchronous, right? So when we delete stuff up there or we're removing stuff, sometimes it disappears from the portal, but it's still there. It hasn't finished yet. It hasn't like finished completed destruction or removal or whatnot. And sometimes customers would say, hey, I deleted this, but it says it still exists. That's not possible. And then if you go through resources.azure.com, you're kind of getting a dump of what's up there, real. There's nothing being filtered there in front of you. And then you can see, no, it's still there. And it's, you know, in the deletion process or something like that. And then you would know you just have to wait a little bit and you'll be able to replay it. So it's great for if you start running into those issues where you see like the portal shows something, but it doesn't kind of jive right. If you go out to resources.azure.com, great dump tool to kind of see what's happening. The export tool is absolutely awesome for like what Ed said, when you want to replicate environments, creating a QA environment, and then, you know, spinning up maybe your production off of that and using that as your base template kind of thing. Really great for that. And so that wraps the session on resource providers and ARM in Azure.